Live from Dietrich Gymnasium in New Britain, Connecticut, it's Northeast Conference Women's Basketball, the semifinals of the postseason tournament. Tonight's matchup, the top-seeded Central Connecticut State Blue Devils hosting the St. Francis of Brooklyn Terriers, the number 5 seed.
Fetchko, left side to Ailey Simpson. Fetchko, the triple, Leah Fetchko, she puts them on the board. Looking in the post again. Vinay turns, hits. Stacey Ellingery, a redshirt freshman. She's played great ball for head coach Burrow Piper this year. To the basket is Vinay, and one. Vinay over Harrington, that one falls.
Vinay does a good.
Left side, Fetchko. Benedetti in the post this time. Vinay the triple.
Wow, St. Francis is doing a really good job of playing inside-out basketball.
Central scrambling now. Benedetti drives baseline, three to play. Miss, rebound by Central, and that's the first half, and an intense defensive-oriented first half.
Two other players got a little bit of minutes, whereas Central Connecticut's shuffling a lot of players.
Even that goes in. Benedetti just chucks it up there with the classic hook shot. Wallacek spins. Good closeout on Watrous. Not on Wallacek, and she nails the triple.
It has that refuse to lose mentality. They said, don't count us out just yet.
Watrous to the hoop with this basket. But she missed the season with a very serious injury, so she's not, doesn't have a ton of experience even though she's a senior. Benedetti the triple, good. Full shot clock, plenty of time here, but Musgrave forces the three and hits it. down three with 5 seconds to go. Wallacek the trigger.
She's going with her more experienced players.
Hand it to Wallacek, through to shoot. Pass deflected by Simpson out of bounds. 0.6 seconds to go. Simpson celebrates slightly premature. They still have 0.6 seconds to get off a shot. Watchers to inbound. Can't find anybody. Hits Malone. Has the triple.
Oh!
Jesus!
It's good! It's good!
Knocks down the three-point shot, and we are headed to overtime. Benedetti the triple. Matchup. That means if Central Connecticut wins, they will host Robert Morris here on Sunday. But if Brooklyn wins, they will go to Robert Morris on Sunday. Watrous, open three. Got it.
Watrous is playing out of her mind tonight.
Hands it off to Epps, and she's going to hold for final shot. 10 seconds to play.
High pick and roll.
6 seconds to play. There's the screen. Epps comes off it to the hoop. Layup. No good. Rebound Harrington. Can't finish. Knocked away. Out of bounds. And we are heading to a second overtime here in New Britain, Connecticut. They won at Sacred Heart in Connecticut in the quarterfinals in the upset.
Well, that's the beauty of tournaments. It's a new season. Whatever you did prior to that doesn't matter.
And Central will not foul. Ailey Simpson runs out the clock. And the St. Francis Brooklyn Terriers are heading to Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania to take on the Robert Morris Colonials in the NEC Finals on Sunday afternoon.
All right, John, thanks so much. Jamie, let me turn to you first. This looked to be an exhausting game to play, and I feel exhausted just watching it. How was it like to play at it?
Very tiring. It was a lot of up and down. 13 is a very great player, so, you know, I had to play really good defense. And on the offensive end, she's a good defender, so, you know, I had to work my butt off on offense to get my shots off.
You had a great first half. It led to another double-double. What was working for you so well, especially early on in the game?
My teammates were passing to me, and I was just, you know, feeling good after I got the jitters out in the first 10 minutes. You know, once my shots started falling, you know, and then started making kickouts and everyone else started hitting shots, it just rolled from there.
And now this team having to come back several times, they hit that three late in the game just to force overtime. So what were you thinking having to go play 5 more minutes and then eventually 10 more minutes?
That's just 5 more minutes and 10 more minutes to build another lead.
This group of seniors that you're a part of, you know, has been instrumental in helping build this program back to the point where now St. Francis is getting set to play in their very first NEC championship game. So what was it like, the final buzzer sounding and all that group, that core group, realizing, hey, we got one more game to play?
You know, it was obviously exhausting, but, you know, the adrenaline and, you know, having won and not been to a championship, it's just great. And to say that, you know, we came in and we did that is just a beautiful feeling.
Jamie, congratulations. We'll let you go celebrate.
Thank you.
Let's turn to talk with Coach Thurston today. Coach, 4 years ago, 0-18 in conference. Yeah. You bring in this core group of seniors. Jamie was one of them, and now here they are getting ready to play in a championship. How proud are you of them?
Well, you know, they've done so much on and off the court. You know, we're probably better academically than we are basketball-wise, which is not a bad thing to be. Our goal every year is to win the academic national championship. We've been close, and wherever basketball takes us, we're happy. But they've worked very, very hard in the offseason. They're a very close-knit group. You know, and that's a recipe for success. When you have intelligent people who know what it takes to be successful, and generally those kids who are used to working very hard towards a goal, and they've worked extremely hard. We've had our downs this year, as I told you the other day, because of injuries, but we're getting healthy and we're playing good basketball, and, you know, what the heck, let's play another game.
Since Valentine's Day, really, the last couple weeks of the season, now here in two playoff games, the team has really come along. And, you know, especially here today on the road, the home team hits a late shot to force overtime, crowds going nuts, hostile environment, but yet your team didn't lose your composure. Yeah. What was the message?
Well, it shows you what great coaching is. I said, if you're going to let anybody shoot the ball, let 40 shoot it.
She was 1-for-3 career from behind
right.
the arc.
Well, that's what I said. If anybody's going to get a three off, let 40 shoot it. So absolutely fabulous coaching on my part. So she makes that shot. But what I was happy with is, you know, you could really go down. You could put your head down. And I thought it was really important that we stress that we score first in the first overtime to get us back in a positive feeling. And we did that. And there's an old thing in basketball that the team that scores first in overtime wins the game. All right. And that proved to be true.
Now, we had a Robert Morris St. Francis Brooklyn championship game just yesterday. How can the women's basketball team for St. Francis Brooklyn make the result a little bit different this time around?
Oh, I don't know. We have a thing that we don't think about the next game until today is over. Today we only enjoy this game, and we're going to enjoy it all the way back to Brooklyn, and then we'll start to think about the next one then. But right now we're not going to think about it. I want our younger players to remember this feeling that they have right now, and that'll give them something to work for in the future.
Well, Coach, you have a couple more hours left of today to enjoy this one before I know you start getting the game plan ready for Sunday, but we'll see you in Pittsburgh for the championship.
All right, thank you very much.
Congratulations. Right. John, it's 3-5 in the final, just like we all predicted, right? It's Robert Morris in St. Francis, Brooklyn once again. We'll see them Sunday, and of course, we'll be here an hour beforehand on NEC Front Row for NEC Front Row Live. Back to you.